Right, we're looking at percentage of a number. We're going to be doing it two different ways, each one two different ways. So you might have a calculator, you might not have a calculator. So I'm going to show you how to do both. All right, now 15% is basically, if you think of 15% as 10% and 5%, that makes it easier to do without a calculator. So I can find 10% of a number. All right, how many lots of 10% are in 100%? All right, and that would be 10, wouldn't it? So 10% of 120 is 120 divided by 10, which is 12 pounds. Okay, now if I know 10%, I can find 5% nice and easily, because that's going to be half of what 10% is. So there you go, add them up, I get 18. So that's one way of doing it. That would be the way to do it without a calculator. If I had a calculator, I would just do 120 divided by 100. That gives me 1% times by 15, which would also give me 18. I'd use my calculator. And if you think about it, this bit here, all right, actually, I could do as 0.15. I could convert 15% into a decimal. So that's another way of doing it. And that's something when you go into percentage change, you might want to bear in mind. Well, if I'm finding 90%, actually, 90%, you could find 10% times it by 9. That's a little bit more difficult than I actually find. The times it by 9 bit's not very nice. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to say, well, 90% is 100%, take away 10%. All right, so I can once again work out 10% nice and easily. So 10% of 55 pounds is 5 pounds 50. All right, and I'm going to do now 55 pounds take away 5 pounds 50, which equals 49 pound 50. So there you go, that's one way of doing it without a calculator. Now I'm just going to change color, I'm going to go to orange this time. If I had a calculator, I would just do 55 divide by 100 times by 90, which would also give me 49 pounds 50. Okay, but again, I could call this bit, I could do it as a decimal, and 90% you should know as a decimal is 0.9. So there's a couple of different ways there. It depends whether you've got a calculator or you haven't, really. But there you go. So to find 10%, you can find 5%, and you can work from there, essentially.